What I do have to consider when measuring smallest magnetic fields and where it is used in practice, this and more you will find out now. Today we would like to do an accurate magnetic field measurement, and for this we take a magnetoscope and a Foerster probe. When I hold the probe in my hand like this, the magnetic field signal changes all the time, and we measure the Earth magnetic field and other static fields in different positions. So let's fix a probe. That's much better. Our signal remains stable. Not really. My smartphone in my pocket causes a magnetic field, so make sure there are no people walking around your measurement setup. And don't move around with chairs. And don't position your measurement station close to large machines like this milling machine. To reduce disturbing fields, a differential probe can be used. Whew! Now we have our stable measurement setup with a differential probe. So now we can start to measure very small magnetic fields. Components like these are used in MRI systems. For components in MRI systems, it is very important that they don't have any residual magnetic field. So now we can start to measure. Before we start, we should make a zero compensation. So press this button, we make a compensation, and then we should have 0 nanotesla on our view. Sure, we have still some disturbing influences, but it is enough for a good measurement quality. So now I can move this part in front of the probe. So we see, okay, this part causes 22 nanotesla. So there's a small residual field. So this component cannot be used in an MRI system. If we try that with this component, there's no signal, so we have no residual magnetic field, and we can use this component in our system. Any other component which needs to have no residual magnetic field, like MineDeeper equipment, or components which needs to have a really accurate magnetic field, like banknotes, they are measured in the same way. Magnetic field measurement is of course used in many other areas. Today we focused mainly on really sensitive applications. If you enjoyed our video, subscribe to our channel and see you next time.